I'm gonna share a story from the desert, right? From when I was in Somaliland, East Africa, teaching at an all-women's university. There was one incident that occurred on campus, right? The students decided to have a riot and showed out, right? It was a huge ordeal. It's not funny, but hindsight, right? So they did a lot of things. There was a lot of vandalism. Things happened on campus that they weren't proud of, and I wasn't proud of as their professor and their like fill-in guardian, right? Those are my babies. Their parents weren't there, so they were in my care. So I wasn't proud of their behavior. And I remember afterwards, we were having meetings with staff just to how to address the problem. And I was teaching a community development course at that time, and this was for our upperclassmen. And I was co-teaching that. And I remember the individual that I was co-teaching with, I asked if I can teach the upcoming class, right? So I put together a PowerPoint presentation and I wanted them to hear a message from someone who looked like them in regards to their behavior. And my biggest thing to them was that if you want to be heard, the best way to be heard is not to yell and scream. Right? Kicking and screaming doesn't really have someone hear you. They just see your actions. And when I had the class, I remember sharing with them something that I found from Black Lighting, and I'm going to share it with you. It was like Black Lighting is a TV show about a black superhero, right? So he started off one of his classes. He would do this call and response, and he would start with, "Where's the future?" The students would say, "Right here." "Whose life is this?" "Mine." "So what are you going to do with it?" "Live it by any means necessary." Right? And I would start my class off from then on out. My students knew, like, this is how I wanted to start class, because you need to take responsibility for your actions and your life and how you show up. People treat you how you show them how to treat you. And then I went through the whole, had a whole presentation on, like, Birmingham, Alabama, and how it was referred to as Bombingham, Alabama, and the four little girls. And I even did a research paper on that in high school, and just showing how the civil rights movement, as much as violence could have been used by black Americans, it wasn't a lot of times, right? Like, they got their word across through silent protests, and just showing the ladies, next time, have a clear message, be clear and intentional about what it is you're trying to receive, and use your voice that way. And teaching them that your voice is your wand. It is your most powerful tool. Use it. Stop underestimating it and use it. I even taught them about Trayvon Martin, telling them that I went to that protest. Trayvon was like my nephew. Wasn't my nephew, but my oldest nephew, was around the same age at that time and just resembled him. So as much as you may want to kick and scream and break things and do these things, just be mindful of what your end game is. What is your goal? What do you hope to achieve from this? And are the measures that you're taking matching the results that you wish to receive? And always remember, where's the future? Right here. Whose life is this? Mine's. So what are you going to do with it? I pray and I hope you live it by any means necessary. Love and light. Ebony Aaliyah, your favorite storyteller.